Hi, welcome back to my ongoing discussion of teaching and learning in a makerspace for mypaperlessclassroom.com. I'm Dr. Sam Patterson, and if this is the first time you're joining me, I would encourage you to check out the playlist of makerspace videos, because I've been making them since the beginning of the year, and we're in week 4-5 now. I think this is the fourth video. I got to make sure they're all numbered right, but the span's 2 weeks. Talk about what we've been doing, what we're going to be doing. I'm positive there's a rhythm to these days, and I know I don't have it yet. I haven't missed a duty this week, so I'm showing up where I need to be and having stuff ready for kids, but there's a lot. Doing anything brand new, it's a lot of new preps, it's a lot of new content for me, it's a lot of new kids. And one of the great things we did was we didn't have any tech for the first 3 weeks. The iPads weren't yet working, the kids weren't bringing their laptops to class, so we did a number of tech-free lessons that really gave me an opportunity to have the kids do stuff, mostly with paper, and to talk to them about it and have them think about it without dealing with all of the really trivial issues that come with technology. But this week, we're down with the trivial issues. We've got first grade, pre-K, and second grade all doing programming. We had fourth, fifth, sixth, third all doing really serious documentation stuff. So one of the big things I'm a fan of in the makerspace is getting them to take pictures and tell a story with those pictures, either in video or like today with the fourth graders, they were just throwing them into a Google Doc. I think I'll use slides next time for that, because pictures in a Google Doc, really challenging. If I'd had them put it in slides, I think they would have had a lot more success. And there was nothing I was asking them to do that was essentially Google Doc necessary. It didn't have to look like a Word document. But documentation is really big. I want the kids to document their process, and I want them actually to document their process. And this is a challenge for them, because they want to create the document they think I want to see. Saw this all the time with my English class kids. And what I'm trying to do is get them to take their off-task behavior and bring that into the makerspace. And, well, it's already in the makerspace. Bring that into their documentation and show that off task. If you spent 20 minutes making figures out of Play-Doh that you didn't need to make, let's include some pictures of those figures out of Play-Doh. So if nothing else, your documentation shows what you spent the time on. And that's a message that I think it's going to take a long time to get kids to buy into. There's a big difference between that and having them intentionally film blooper reels, which is something that almost every student I've ever taught wants to do. And it's always a challenge to work with them to get them to understand that blooper reels are the accidents that actually happen when you're trying to film well. But if you're never trying to film well, you don't actually have a blooper reel. You just have bad film footage. We've been at this a month. Time is flying. What are we learning right now? And are we in the right place? Pre-K. We've done a lot of building. We've done some working together. We're going to put them on iPads for the first time this week with a tool called Puzzlets. And it's a programming app that you use little puzzle pieces and actually put them in this cloud work playboard to give the commands to the app. And we'll see how well that works. Kindergarten this week did an awesome design project. They designed shade structures, and we put ice cold lemonade underneath the little shade structures they designed. They took its temperature over course of time to see which structures did the best job maintaining the temperature of the lemonade and which ones did not. And it was about 100 degrees that day, which is really hot. And that was a really good day to do that. First grade this week, we started with ScratchJr. It was their first time on the iPad. I found my iPad safety for first grade video that I'd done for the last school, and I brought that back into my regular YouTube channel so you can actually see that now. It's closed captioned. I captioned that for you. So it's available if you have first graders and you don't want them to drop their iPads. It's a great short video that basically says, don't drop your iPads, first graders. Third grade did a great job this week. You can actually see some of the pieces right over there on the wall. Those little orange tags are boats that the teachers designed, and the third graders designed platforms or display shelves for those boats to sit on. And if they survive until next week in here, we're going to transfer them out onto the bulletin board. So they will have the bulletin board that show to showcase the teacher's work. Because as I told the kids, the teachers spend a lot of time figuring out how to showcase student work. So this was an opportunity to kind of help them out in return and to show off the teacher's work. Fourth grade today just finished their first how-to document, and we actually had them stand up and share that with each other. It took a class and a half, and they created a little circuit out of either little bits or circuit blocks. They decided what they wanted their circuit to be. They created a document that showed what parts you needed, a step-by-step how to do it, and then they shared that with everybody in kind of a stand and deliver style of presentation. There were some students who didn't want to present today, and that was okay because this was a choice presentation mode. There'll be other times where we really encourage them and basically compel them all to present. But we heard from a majority of the kids, and they shared the document they created. Fifth grade did a similar project, but they did use Google Slides for the documentation for their Makey Makey exploration, and that was really good. Google Slides worked really well, and it was much easier for them to work with the photos in Google Slides than it was for them to work with the photos in Google Docs. And finally, in sixth grade, we're in week two of a three-week Makey Makey build. They're either building an operation-style game in Makey Makey or a musical instrument in Makey Makey with their partner, and they have to have some sort of Scratch programming for that to interact with. So that's really where we are with each of our grade levels, and you can see that we have kind of a growing level of complexity grade over grade. We've just started talking about the I-squared projects, the inquiry and innovation student choice projects that are going to begin in January. And we're trying to figure out what is the structure of those projects going to be, how much choice is built into it, how do we support the students in that choice to make sure they all make good choices that reflect their values and interests. I hope that you have an opportunity to do this kind of work with your students. You get into their interests and you help support them in their learning in order to empower them to be independent learners. Until next time, I'm Sam Patterson on My Paperless Classroom. Please click subscribe. Subscribe to this channel so that you can get all of the updates that show up on the YouTube. And be sure to check out the blog at mypaperlessclassroom.com and my writing on programming in the elementary school classroom that you can find at beyondtheHourOfCode.com. Thank you.